Shalom. This is the continuation to the video what I did yesterday. You know, what I was saying in the end is that the brother Kalab was come up with the either put on the group chat, I think, in the on WhatsApp. The type of God loves everybody on the Bible or whatever. I ain't gonna see that. So then who is this power these Christian churches that we worshiping? Because if it is that your type of God loves everybody in the Bible that they claim they use, and you don't see no form or no trace of the scripture, say no verse, no chapter, no word put in the same sentence as God loves everybody in the same Bible, then who is this God that them claiming say love everybody? Understand? Who is this God? The God of the community, who is that? I think is Baal Berith, if I'm mistaken. The God of the community, that is Caesar Borgia, the world-friendly God and a world-friendly doctrine. But the power of the Bible, alright, is the power of Israel. He says the power of Abraham, the power of Isaac, the power of Jacob. You understand? Nowhere else you will see in the Bible, I am the power of Edom, also the power of Moab, and even the power of Elam. No, you ain't going to see that. You understand? So the Son of the Most High and the Most High, if they are one, they will be corresponding with each other. So you people who like to say the Old Testament done away with and the New Testament is what we're dealing with now. If Jesus Christ is the Son of the Most High and the Son of the Most High and the Father is one, they're supposed to resonate with each other. You understand? So some people like to say the God of the Old Testament only like to kill, and then Jesus come in and he bring in peace. So yeah, that'll resonate with each other if there is one. Same thing, the Father delighting, the Son delighting. You understand? So there are no separation. The scripture says Yahushua divided. Yahushua not divided. So bottom line is, you people who worship in Christ, you're worshiping an idol. You're worshiping an idol. Matter of fact, idolatry is folly on a next level, because it have no profit in it. The gods that you're worshiping can do nothing to help you any time of trouble. It ain't going to do nothing to help you when Yahweh Ba'asham Yahushua bring down that judgment upon the earth. This is Wisdom of Solomon chapter 13, verse 10. It says, but miserable are they, and in dead things is their hope, who call them gods, which are the works of men's hands, gold and silver to show art in, and resemblances of beasts, or a stone good for nothing, the work of an ancient hand. Alright? Now a carpenter that felled timber, alright? Now that meaning a man who has cut down trees, after he had sawn down a tree meet for the purpose, and taken off all the bark skillfully round about, and had wrought it handsomely, and made a vessel thereof fit for the service of man's life. So he do his skill, he perform his skill after he cut down the tree. He used the piece of lumber to do his skill. Alright? And after spending the refuse of his work to dress his meat, had filled himself, and taking very refuse among those which serve to no use, being a crooked piece of wood, alright, the piece that he use for, he take that, and full of nuts, had carved it diligently. He take a piece of wood. Now this is a man. Cut down a tree. Use the tree for his good to get his done, to get his dollar, to get his pay. And the little remainders of the tree, alright? He carved it diligently when he had nothing else to do and formed it by the skill of his understanding and fashioned it into the image of a man, or made it like some vile beast, laying it over with vermilion and with paint, coloring it red and covering every spot therein. And when he had made a convenient room for it, set it in a wall and made it fast with iron, for he provided for it that it might not fall, knowing that it was unable to help itself, for it is an image and had need of help. So basically, Solomon dissing him. You understand? You greater than this thing, and you're building up you're building up something to bow down to, that you self greater than. That is same thing with Caesar Borgia, because you greater than this man. That was a normal man who walked the earth about 400 or 500 years ago. You understand? A man. He was no god or nothing. He was just a man. It says, for he provided for it that it might not fall, knowing that it was unable to help itself. And that is the same thing with these powers out here who you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans bow down to. It can't help itself. So you had to help it. You had to go and carry food for it. You had to constantly feed Jesus in hopes that Jesus will feed you back. That fucking devil called JC. The reason why I'm saying that name, I don't really like to say that name, but I'm saying it for edification purposes. Because I have a serious problem with this. I have a problem with this power, because this so-called God, because this man don't help nobody. All the man does just do is love everybody, then love you, and whatever you do wrong, he love you still. And that is the same God that Nate does pray to. You understand? A power with no judgment is not a power. Scripture says, do good, do evil, that we may know that ye are gods. The brother was bringing out that, looking for that earlier. Let me see if I find it. Yeah, so I cannot do good, do evil. I had it mixed up. It's Isaiah 41:23. It says, show the things that are to come hereafter, that we may know that ye are powers, that ye may know that ye are gods. Yea, do good or do evil, that we may be dismayed and behold it together. You understand? So show me prophecies, show me these things. That's why the scripture says the spirit of Yahushai is the spirit of prophecy, because that's where Yahushai does show you. He does show you prophecies. And hey, just today I'm saying this. Yahushai say that the Most High Yahweh Ba'asham Yahushai say that hey, I'm going to bring a mark of the beast. The mark of the beast in effect. ICBM missiles, the ICBM missiles in effect. You seen them thing building. Alright? He say he going and set up Esau to rule over. We are seeing that happening. He say he going and put we in captivity in cargo slave ships. You see that take place. He say he going and bring me down and make me be the lowest nation on the earth. You see that take place. He say we women going and be harlots in the streets. You see that taking place. So then, if you seen all of this taking place, why when he say we go and receive the kingdom of heaven, you don't believe? Why when he say You're going and receive eternal life once you believe. You don't believe. Why when he say you're going and rule over these heathen nations, once you keep the faith, you don't believe. And everything else what he say, he bringing it to pass. So what makes it any different? He going, the scripture say the Most High is slack concerning his promise to prove. You know what I going to prove? That I exist, that he exists in the word. That's why he not slack concerning promise, because he going to prove that he exists. He's actually a power that lives. Not like these fake powers where you're worshipping out here. We are the feed continually. Because you people, you jakes, you just constantly go and feed Caesar Borgia by giving him a so-called tithes and offering. You understand? In hopes that he will give you back something. Caesar Borgia is a dead dog. He's a dead dog. He's not a power. He can't do good. He can't do evil. Because all he could do is good. In this so-called Christian's life, all the man can do is good. He can't do no bad at all. And if he can do, if he can bring judgment, scripture say, Psalms chapter 9 verse 16. It says Yahweh Hashem Yahushai is known by the judgment which he executed. So that is how we go know the Lord, because the Lord has bring judgment to pass. The wicked is snared in the works of his own hands. Alright? So the Most High will, you will know the Most High when you see judgment passing. So if Caesar Borgia, as you people call him, is the son of the Most High, why is no judgment passing from this man? I'm putting questions to all you, ask all yourself these things. This man don't bring to pass no judgment. All he does do is say he love. But I could tell you something. Yahweh Shai, the son of God, the so-called black man from the tribe of Judah, from the seed of David, who come here in the flesh, who walked the earth, who died for the sins of the nation of Israel, the elect sins first. You see that so-called black man, as people will call him if he was on the earth today, that so-called black man, he know how to do judgment. The scripture says, for judgment's sake I am coming to the world. That's what the Lord say. You understand? He know how to do judgment properly. He is the one who does. He don't love everybody. Because he said, the prince of this world cometh and have nothing in me. I'm talking about the actual son of the Most High. Yahweh Shai is his name, and he's a so-called black man from the tribe of Judah. But Caesar Borgia, that devil, that demon, that so-called white man, who you people call Jesus Christ, have none to do with the Most High, because he's a son of the wicked. Jesus Christ is one of the sons of the wicked. As Apostle Eliphaz said, Jesus is actually a demon. Every time you call on that name, it's a demon you're calling on. Yahweh Shai, he deliverer, is the name of the son of the Most High. And you're going to know that, you see, when he come to bring that judgment on the earth, that's what the scriptures say, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai is known by the judgment which he executed. When you see, when he bring that judgment on the earth, you people go and realize, that is, yeah, this is the true power. This is the true power. And you ain't going to be hearing Jesus in that day. Hell no. Hell no. Nobody ain't going to be saying Jesus Christ. Nobody ain't going to be saying Allah. Nobody ain't going to be saying Buddha. Nobody ain't going to be saying Shiva Ganesh. Nobody ain't going to be saying Hotep. Nobody ain't going to be saying freaking ISIS. Nobody ain't going to be saying who it have again? These Hamitic gods who you freaking black unconscious community coons as worship. Nobody gonna be calling out that name, because the scripture say Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai is known by the judgment which he executed. You understand? That is Psalms 9 verse 16. So when he bring that judgment on the earth, you're gonna know is who it is. the power, the God, all right, who the Hebrew Israelites, mainly from Great Millstone, have been exalting in the earth. That is where you're going to know who it is. And you're going to realize the powers who you've been serving, the gods who you've been serving and bowing down to, have no power in their hands to save or to do good or to do evil. All they have is just a pretty look, because you yourself dress them up. Just like Wisdom of Solomon was saying. Just like Wisdom of Solomon was saying. So going back in. It says, Wisdom of Solomon chapter 13 verse 17. Then maketh he prayer for his goods, for his wife, for his and children, and is not ashamed to speak to that which hath no life. It says, for health, he calleth upon that which is weak. For life, pray to that which is dead, and for aid, humbly beseecheth that which hath least means to help. And for a good journey, he asketh of that which cannot set a foot forward. Alright? So that is you people today. Okay? You keep going to these fake powers, these fake gods who can't help you in no kind of way possible. And praying to it. A power or a god will you self set up in your mind. Because, as I say, that so-called image, that so-called white man image, is not the Son of the Most High. That is an image you put in your mind, or rather, your oppressors from the time of slavery put in your brain to worship. That is why your mind had to be renewed and come into the truth, into the true light. And that is when you will realize that, hey, This man was lying all the time to me. You understand? That is when you go realize that. But until that, you go and be blinded. I will just read this verse and close. And for gaining and getting, and for good success of his hands, asketh ability to do of him that is most unable to do anything. But the evidence of Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai is here in the earth. Alright? It is here in the earth. This is Hebrews chapter 1, verse chapter 11, verse 1. And it reads, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good report. It says, true faith. We understand that the worlds were framed by the word of the Most High, so that the things which are seen, what we could see, all right, were not made of things which do appear. Okay? The things what we could see, they weren't made of things which do appear. We understand that it's something greater made this. That is what we understand. True faith. Something greater create all this. This didn't just morph into existence. Something was creating it. The evidence are the things not seen. Because we ain't seeing Yahweh, why Yahweh shy. But we understand that this didn't come here just so. Because we seen these things, and the things which do appear is man just appearing. Man didn't create the things what we see in Solia. Some greater creator. You understand it? So I cut that hole. Evolution bullshit what Esau like to push on the world. Tawara Yahweh Baasham Yahushai. So with that, I'm going to close off and say Tawara Yahweh Baasham Yahushai for the wisdom, understanding that you bestowed upon the apostles, a great millstone for them to bestow it upon the Akim who diligent, Lord, and Akim, I will say this, pray for diligence, pray for faith to push on through and endurance to endure all things for Yahweh Baasham Yahushai name's sake. You understand? And pray to get the fuck out of here too. So hopefully you've been edified, you know. And if you feel that through the Spirit I went off on anything, you know, you leave your comments and I would correct it, you know. So Shalom Kalakyam Yahweh Baasham Yahushai Barakatam. Hopefully you've been edified. Double honors to the apostles are great millstone, and all praises to Yahweh Baasham Yahushai. These are my one signing out. Jesus Christ have nothing to do with the Holy Bible. It's Yahweh Shai, Son of the Most High. And we had to kill the so-called white man called Jesus Christ and his philosophies. You understand? When I mean kill him, I mean we had to kill all this. Matter of fact, let me just read this last precept, because somebody might say I want to kill somebody on a physical level. And it's not how I mean. I mean we had to kill this wicked system that he set in place. When the Most High give you the power, we will physically, when the Most High, Yahweh, Baasham Yahushai, give us the power, we will physically take him down. But right now, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but spiritual. It's 2 Corinthians 12, 10, verse 3. It says, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through the Most High, to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of the Most High, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Yahweh Shai. You understand? So that is what I mean, we have to kill the so-called white man called Jesus Christ through the Spirit, through the prophecies, and exalt the true and living power Yahweh Baasham Yahweh Shai, which according to the Bible is so-called black men with woolly hair. Alright? So, with that, hopefully you've been edified again. Until the next time, Shalom to the elect.